so glad you're here. Thank you for taking a little bit of time to sit with me. I hope that together we can relax, deepen our breathing, settle into ourselves, hopefully reduce any levels of anxiety that might be high. And if you would like to close your eyes and fall asleep, you are more than welcome to do so. So right now, we're just going to start with a little bit of breathing. You can go ahead and get into your most comfortable position, whether that is sitting up with nice straight posture, maybe tuck your chin down just a little bit to get yourself in alignment. We don't want our necks to be craning up or looking down too much, just a gentle sort of floaty posture that's comfortable for you. Try to find that. Or if you'd like to lie down and just feel your body relaxing onto the floor, onto your bed, onto a comfortable piece of furniture, whatever feels good to you. And we're going to start by just taking 3 deep breaths in through the nose and out through the mouth, okay? So let's do that together. And one more. Now we're going to deepen and lengthen our breath just a little bit. This will take a tiny bit of focus and effort, but I promise that it will be worth it, because in the long run, this will help you sink into a deeper and calmer and less anxious state. So what we're going to do is double our breath, by which I mean we are going to inhale for a certain count, and then we're going to exhale for double that count. So we'll start with an inhale of 3, and so an exhale of 6, and then we'll work ourselves up to an inhale of 10 and an exhale of 20. And if at any time this is uncomfortable for you, just return to your normal breathing pattern. But I would like to encourage you to, as much as possible, if it's possible and comfortable for you, to breathe in and out through your nose and let your lips remain gently together. So I will count for you to make it easier, and we'll just breathe a little bit together. And partway through, we might take a little bit of a resettling breath, just a little break where you just will take one normal breath returning to the count. So let's start. We're going to start with an inhale for the count of 3 and an exhale for 6. And please do relax and close your eyes. So here we go. So we're going to breathe in 2, 3 and out 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In 2, 3, 4. Out 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. In 2, 3, 4, 5. And out 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You're doing great. Take a little reset breath. And breathe in 2, 3, 4, 5. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. In, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And out, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. In, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And out, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Reset your breath, and as you breathe in for the 9 and the 10, focus on breathing in first to your belly and then into your chest, filling yourself up. And here we go. In, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And out, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. And now our last long breath. In, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And out, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Return to your body's natural breathing rhythm and try to breathe in and out through your nose. I hope you feel a little bit more relaxed already. Now, what I want to talk about is going back to the breath, beginning with the breath, but thinking about how you are sustained and what that means. Take a moment to think about what sustainability means to you. You might think about taking care of the planet. You might think about financial sustainability of something that you are putting money toward. You might think about the sustainability of your own personal energy, how much energy you have to do things in everyday life, and how much rest you need in order to continue doing life. Our breath is the first job we have when we enter the world. We are born and we breathe. Breath sustains us. When you think about it, you need very, very little in this life. And if you can breathe, you have the first and most basic building block of being a human. So take a moment and just enjoy that. You also need food, shelter. I think it's very important to have love in your life. For me, touch is important, and connection with others. We are very connected as humans. interesting creature. I was watching something the other day, and it was talking about the hive mind that is experienced by bees and how they work together. That's experienced by wildebeests and how they travel together. The way that ants build amazing structures together, even though individually their brains are small and they wouldn't be able to do any of that. And I started thinking about how we are so special as humans to have the gift of individuality in a way that only a few other creatures come close to. But we also are all part of each other, and we're part of this world organism. It's so important to take care of yourself, to love yourself. And by that, I am not talking about being selfish or self-centered, but about really finding contentment and in discovering that most of what you need is already right there, that who you are is who you are very, very much meant to be. I am so happy that you are you. I'm so grateful that you and I are connected to each other and that we have some very different experiences from one another. Thank you for having your experiences. Because as part of this human organism, there is no way that we can all have all of the experiences, but we can share our with each other. So, what I'm getting at is that we sustain ourselves, but we do not only sustain ourselves. We practice breath, practice finding these spaces of comfort right within our own bodies, within our own minds and souls. And that's so important, to be able to, in some ways, sustain yourself. When we do this, we give the world an incredible gift. If I find that I am happy and content in myself, then I don't have to ask others to try to give me feelings of happiness or contentment. If I find that I am peaceful in myself, then I don't need to be grasping at other things to make me fulfilled or peaceful. I don't have to take in things that I don't need, and enjoy what I do have available to me. For example, sometimes if I feel like life isn't everything I want it to be, maybe I'll go online and start shopping and I'll end up buying something that I could be perfectly happy without. And when that thing comes to me, it's fun, but it isn't going to make me a better person. It isn't going to solve my problems. It isn't going to make me feel light and full inside. But when I spend time quietly breathing and sitting with myself, I do feel light and fullness and contentment. And I do that without asking the world to give me things that I don't need and that perhaps it can't afford to give me. When we sustain ourselves, we take a burden off of our environment. you to think that this means that you have to be entirely self-sufficient. That's not the way that we work as humans either. We are here as caregiver creatures, I believe. We take care of ourselves, but we take care of each other. And we are taken care of by everything around us. We're not a closed circuit. If I were a closed circuit, breathing wouldn't work. But I'm an open circuit. The air is constantly moving in and out of me. It becomes part of me and it leaves me. It becomes part of you and it leaves you. The air sustains us. The ground sustains us. The trees sustain us. When we are with the trees, we are breathing in what they are breathing out, and they are breathing in what we are breathing out. Isn't the world beautiful that way? Everything sustaining everything else. And I think that at our best, humans take care of one another. We take care of one another with the most basic things, with a hug when it's necessary, or the sound of our voices. We work together in collaborative mental states when we talk with one another and share ideas and figure out problems, small and large, together. In no way are you all alone. In no way are you cut off from this world. Even on our loneliest days, we're not actually alone, we're not actually being asked by the world to be self-sufficient. And so you can always return to your breath. So go ahead and take a few calm breaths. Return to that right now with me. Deep gratitude for the air that circulates through us, for the ground that supports us, for our bodies, for each other, and for this planet. You don't need to feel worried or anxious about anything. Let the simplest things sustain. Know that you can always return to these simple things. If you are listening right now, I hope that you feel safe, that you feel loved, that you feel the touch of my voice as something soothing, and most of all, that you feel a sense of fullness and light within yourself that is always, always available to you. Now, to conclude our session here together, I'm just going to give you a little body relaxation. Close your eyes, breathe gently in and out, and going to name the parts of you that we're going to let relax. So go ahead and we'll scan down your body, get you totally relaxed, and I hope that perhaps this will lead you into sleep or into a comforted and comfortable state where you can rest for a little while after we conclude. So, we're going to just relax the top of your head and down your scalp. Let your face relax. deeply relax. Let your cheeks and jaw relax. Let your throat relax and your shoulders drop down away from your ears. Breathe into your chest and let it relax. Breathe into your belly and let it relax completely. Let the muscles in your back sink down into the surface below you. If you're sitting, let all of your sit bones and muscles just relax. Let your ankles a little spin perhaps, and let your feet feel themselves solid and relaxed against the ground, or if you're lying down, let them just rest. Thank you for being here, for being you, and for spending this time with me. And you are so important. You really, really are. All right. Breathe deeply.